everyone, this is Chelsey from the Zulu Wiley Public Library, and today we are going to be doing a hip opening yoga flow. So I'm just going to jump right in. We are going to start with our legs crossed, and we're just going to take a couple of deep breaths. You can rest your hands on your knees. We're just going to breathe in and breathe out. We're going to also roll our shoulders back and breathe in and breathe out. And now I want you guys to reach with our legs still crossed forward. And just go down as far as what feels comfortable to you. And take a couple of deep breaths here. Back up. We're gonna still kind of stay in this position, but we're gonna put our feet together so the bottom of our feet are touching. And we're gonna flap our legs kind of like butterflies. Take some deep breaths in and out. And now we're going to take our right foot and put it on top of our left. So it's almost crisscross, but instead of tucking our right leg underneath our left thigh, we're just gonna rest it on top. And this is called the fire log pose. I'm gonna reach forward as far as what is comfortable to you. Take a couple of deep breaths. We're going to come back up and we're going to switch the cross of our legs. So right leg down on the ground and left leg up, resting on top. I'm going to reach forward again. A couple of deep breaths. Inhaling and exhaling, and maybe every time that you exhale, you sink deeper into your child's pose. You can take a couple of deep breaths here. We're going to inhale and move our hands to the left of the mat and exhale. Inhale our hands to the center of the mat. Exhale. And we're going to inhale our hands to the right of the mat. And exhale. And now we're going to go back to tabletop. We're going to tuck our toes underneath us and push into downward. And we're going to start our hip opening flows. Tuck my shirt in really quick. So we are going to lift our right leg. We've done this in some of our other flows that we've done online. You want to keep your hips level. And now we're going to kind of open up a bit and bend our right leg.
sure that you're able to see your right foot underneath your left arm when you're looking back. This is going to give your hips a nice opening stretch.
We're going to take that right foot and we're going to bring it between the legs. Now we are going to keep our left leg up. We're going to kind of put our right foot more to the side. We're going to take our hands right next to us on the left for lizard pose. You can keep it right here. You can kind of lift up a little bit if this is too much of a stretch for you. You can also go on your forearms if you want a deeper stretch. Whatever feels good for you. Take a couple of deep breaths here. We're going to take our left leg down to the ground into a deep lunge. And what we're going to do next is that we are going to take this right knee and kind of push our leg out for a twisted lunge. You can take your right arm to the sky. Give a nice twisted lunge. And bring your right hand back down. We're going to move our leg back to the center. And we're just going to go up into downward dog again, lifting our right leg in the air for three-legged dog. Take a couple of deep breaths here. And set your right leg down. You're gonna bicycle your legs for a minute. Now we're gonna lift our right leg back up and draw it in. And now we're just gonna bring our leg down in the center for pigeon. You wanna make sure that your hips are still level, even in this position. You don't wanna kind of sink more to one side. You wanna kind of keep yourself propped up. We are in pigeon pose. If you feel so inclined, you could also raise your left leg up for a nice stretch. If that's too much, you can just leave your leg down. You can also come onto your forearms if that feels comfortable for you. You might feel a lot of tension in that right hip joint. And if you do, you can come back up on into the seated position. But if it's comfortable, as you're taking your deep breaths, you can kind of try and just release that tension and sink lower. And with this, you can thread your left arm underneath and lift your right in the air for an even deeper stretch. You can come back to your forearms and then lift back up right here into pigeon. Now we're going to tuck our toes underneath our feet and press back up into our three-legged dog with our right foot up. Inhale and exhale your leg down to the ground. Now we're going to come into plank position.
And we are going to shift forward. And then you can take a chaturanga into upward dog. And now back into downward dog, we are going to repeat the same steps, but on our left leg. So we raise our right leg up and try and keep your hips level. And then we're going to open and bend our left leg. And make sure you can see it under your right shoulder when you're looking back. And we're going to draw our knee forward up to the outside on the left of our hands. We're back in lizard. And keep your right leg up. Knee not touching the ground. And remember, if you want, you could go onto your forearms for a deep stretch. And then what we're going to do is take our right knee down to the ground. And our left knee, we're going to just push out a little bit so you're kind of on the edge of your left foot for a nice lunge, twisted lunge. You can have your right hand sitting on the ground and take your left hand up to the sky. Little deep breaths here. Bring your left hand back down. We're going to go back into three-legged dog. Left leg up. And we're going to go straight into our pigeon pose. We're going to draw our left leg down. And let's hold it for just a second into our bellies. Now we're going to set our left leg down. And it's still going to be bent in this nice triangle. And remember, try not to lean. You don't want your hip rolling off to the side. You want to kind of keep it propped up. Now we're in our pigeon. Take a couple of inhales and exhales right here. And if you would like, you could bend your right leg up and hold on to your foot with your right hand. Onto your forearms, if that feels okay with you. We're going to thread our right arm to the left. And reach our left arm up to the sky. Take some inhales and exhales. Your right toes underneath your right foot. And we're just going to press back up into downward dog. Three-legged dog. Your left leg still up in the air. Take an inhale right here. And then exhale your leg down back to the mat. We're going to come into plank pose. You can float through chaturanga if you want. You can just shift forward in your plank. And then lower slowly up into upward dog. Now we're gonna go back, sit back on your heels, taking your knees wide, back into child's pose. Inhale and exhale. On your exhales, maybe draw your chest down into the ground more. We're going to come into tabletop position. We're going to take a couple of cat and cow poses. We're going to arch our back up. And exhale, draw your belly down towards the ground and your head up. You can do a couple of these on your own. So we're gonna go to standing position. And we are going to do, I've heard it called the yoga squat, but it's the malasana pose or garland pose. And we are going to take our feet as wide as the mat. And we are going to take prayer hands and sink in to garland pose. You can go as far down as you want. You can only go here, that's fine. Or even here, that's great too. Just whatever feels comfortable. And with our garland pose, we want to make sure that the lower back is pulled in, and we want to roll our shoulders back. So that way we're not arching or anything. Roll your shoulders back, your lower back is going to be in. You can use your elbows of your arms to kind of press open your knees, so that way you can get an even deeper stretch. And now we're going to inhale and rise back up. And we are going to go into seated position. And we can roll onto our back. A really great hip opening pose is Happy Baby. So what you're gonna do is take your legs up a little bit, and we're gonna hold onto the sides of our feet. This is called Happy Baby. You can kind of rock from side to side if that feels nice. What you can also do is extend one of your legs. So you can extend your right leg. Bring it back. Extend your left leg. You can extend both legs if you want. And bring that to center. I'm just gonna rock here for just a second. Take some inhales and exhales. And we're going to give our knees a nice hug. And rock here from side to side for a minute as well. And for this next one, we're going to go into our final resting pose. And for this, if you want, you can keep your regular Savasana, just lay flat, palms up to the sky, feet flopping open. You can also kind of draw your legs in and have your feet together like this. I don't know how to explain that one. For a nice hip stretch.
to close our eyes, and at whatever final resting pose that you're in, whether it be Savasana or having your legs like this, we're just going to close our eyes and rest. Gonna be here for another minute. Now I want you to come back into your breathing and deepen it. Do big inhale, big exhale. Wiggle your fingers and your toes. And roll off to our right side. And just thank yourself for taking this time to stretch. And press up back to seated and crisscross. And I just want to thank you for joining in our virtual yoga. And hip opening flows are my favorite kind of flows. I hold a lot of tension in my hips, and some of you might as well. I always feel so much more relaxed when I just take a minute and just do some hip opening poses. So I hope you enjoy. And I hope y'all have a great rest of the week, and I hope y'all have a really great Easter weekend. And that's it. And we all say namaste.
Namaste.